Good evening from Dhaka, Bangladesh people. How are you all doing? Today, finally, I just realized there are some fragrances in my collection, perhaps from the earlier days of my collection in 2016, 15, or say before 2018, some fragrances I forgot to review. One of them was this one right here from House of Jacques Bogart. I have shown this in many lists, powerhouse, longest lasting winter fragrance, but I never did full-on review in English. I did one in Bengali, I think. So someone from that channel, commented on that Bengali channel, Joy Bhai or Brother Joy, could you review this because this is one of my favorite. It's one of my signature scents. I love it a lot. Could you do a full-on English review on this? So I just like, thank you, brother, for reminder. So what I'm going to do, probably he is not in my English channel. I'm going to review this, hopefully, and post this link to that comment section so he can see. I'm doing it for that brother. So tonight, actually, I plan to do another fragrance review. I may do another one because I have plenty of topics to cover. Some lists, some head-to-head, you know, not collision, head-to-head comparison. So I have quite a few fragrance ideas that I always take down on my notebook. I'm not showing you my handwriting because it sucks. So so let's just do this review from House of Jacques Bogart. Okay, first of all, Jacques Bogart is a house. You guys know it's an inexpensive house. They have plenty of fragrances, beast mode fragrances on offer, but most part their fragrances are mostly winter heavy because they're extremely sweet, or let's say powerhouse, or you know, like very pungent kind of fragrances. So you cannot really pull them off in summer's time. I found only two or three fragrances that are summer wearable, and the rest of them I have around 20 that I tried. They're all summer heavy, winter heavy. So the fragrance we're gonna look at today, it's a kind of like a flanker of the original that is called Jacques Bogart Silver Scent. I think I did a review on this one, okay? I'm not sure. If I don't, I didn't, I will. So this is one of my easily, I always say, bang for buck. I mean, these are damn cheap. You can find these within $20 budget anywhere in the world. These are not super expensive unless their fragrances get discontinued or hard to find, then they jump up to 50, 60. There are like few fragrances, they are kind of expensive, like Jacques Bogart Signature, few other fragrances that I noticed, they are way pricier. But these ones, they are pretty much available in the market, 100 ml, and it's all engraved. This kind of bottle they come in, they're all same bottle design, little bit colorish in here and they're different. So this is the original silver scent, very pungent, strong, sweet, a youthful kind of fragrance. Then I have actually all in all four, but one is like Midnight Fantasy or something, I forgot, Midnight Blue Bottle. I'm missing that in this line. Then I had Silver Scent Deep. This is much more wearable version of original Silver Scent. This is much more like polite. You can wear this for work and school, right? So this is the deep version. Okay, I reviewed that one. And I call this matte black bottle, like the Lamborghini Aventador or anything that's cool, you know, very beautiful matte black bottle. So even though these are inexpensive, they are very, very interesting. And then the one I said something is wearable in summer is Silver Scent Pure. It has the litchi note, some fruity note, and a lot of sweetness. This is also very, very pungent, but it's wearable. That apple up top, mint up top, and that, you know, litchi, that makes it beautiful. So very hard to find this one. This is a little bit more pricey, $25 or something. So I wear this for summer and winter also. So the one that I'm going to be reviewing today is the strongest, supposedly the strongest version of all of them. That is called Intense. And I would like to apologize because I do not have the box. Since this is my earlier day buys, I keep my boxes. I do not throw away my boxes unless my bottles get finished. This box somewhere is in there, deep down in the boxes or storeroom. I'm so sorry, I can't show you, but I'll put a picture. You can see. Exact similar bottle next to Silver Scent. Okay. Exact same bottle, but it says Intense here, red. And the red actually represents danger. Like if you see, there is a plant that has nuclear activities going on, they'll put like a danger, sort of a hazard, this kind of a font, red. So this is very nuclear. I saw one of the reviewer, George, I think he is a British reviewer. He used to review a lot back in the days, but nowadays he's not very regular, but I like his reviews. So he said this is nuclear, this is like bombastic, and this is so dangerous that you do not over apply this fragrance. Let me tell you what you should expect. So first of all, I'm not gonna spray this on my skin because I just had a shower, and I'm wearing this one, my favorite. This is, I'm very weak for this fragrance now, CK1 Gold. I featured this in one of my recent videos, and see how much I wore it. I keep showing you. Yes, from yesterday even the juice level came down because I am wearing about, I think about 14 sprays of this. Let's go two more. Okay, this is a sweet fragrance. fruity, citrus, kind of like oody sweet, but this disappears very, very quickly from me. So I really love this after shower. Very refreshing fig note in this and citruses. So that I'm gonna be wearing, so that's why I'm not wearing this to mix it up. Let's spray this and show you the sprayer. So built-in sprayer here, not try to take the cap off. It's all plastic. This part is glass, intense Jacques Bogart Paris. Bottom, it's all gonna be engraved. You can see the writing is not sticker, okay? So all in one bottle. And if you actually put LED through this, you can see the juice level moving inside. My juice level is here. So you can tell I did not use much of it. The reason is you do not need much of it, I'll tell you. So the sprayers sometimes are kind of shit. Sometimes it has a pissy kind of sprayer, it just gives out water. Sometimes it sprays. So this one, they do that all the time. Let's see what you get today. As you can see, it's shooting like watery spray. Not very, you know, I wouldn't say very nice sprayer, but they do like shoot like the juice properly. But be careful, shoot in the air first. See, it does that. So you have to see which one, how you're supposed to spray. So anyway, let's try this. So this fragrance is extremely sweet. Very, very sweet as it gets. If you think your palm is sweet, I have your palm somewhere there. Hold on. They're all within the reach, but collecting dust sometimes. Your palm. This and this, if you love this, you might want to take a look at this, because your is candy, floss, syrupy sweet at its best. Even this is sweeter than Yop. So if you like sweet fragrances, you're gonna absolutely love it. This one has a beautiful opening. Let me tell you the seasons for this. This fragrance will be good for winters. Cold weather, it's gonna perform. It's gonna really last on you 8-10 hours plus on your skin. If you put it on your shirt, 2 days, you're gonna smell this all over. Even third, fourth day, you're gonna smell the fur dry down. Sometimes I noticed it when I use this on my clothing like heavily during winter times. And I went through, like, let's say, wash that t-shirt, like, you know, washing machine and stuff. It comes out, it still smells faint smell of this. Potency is crazy. Many fragrances. This is like, what? $20 and less, right? It's like, I think Bangladesh markets, 1,500 taka plus tax. So that is not expensive at all. But this fragrance, the intense version, you cannot find it everywhere. The regular one, the other Jacques Bogart, but this is very hard to find. So I think this particular one is a little bit more pricey. I think I paid $25 for it because I got it from overseas. So yeah, a lot of information. So many EDPs and Pure Parfum cannot beat this performance. So even if you pay $25, let's say $25, and you get 100 ml, and this fragrance lasts more than most of your other fragrances that cost $50, $100 over, you see value-wise, that's why Jacques Bogart is king in this kind of category. So yeah, many kind of notes in this is like multi note combination. But this fragrance, first of all, who is it for? I think it's very youthful, and it's just same as original silver scent, but much more amped up. Original silver scent is bombastic, but this has even double the performance of that. So it's crazy. It's like as strong as it gets. I'm telling you, performance, longevity, projection, 10. Versatility, perhaps not that good. You don't want to wear this in high heat, but if you're a kind of guy, you want performance, you don't care for weathers, put one spray or two sprays, it will serve you very well for the whole day, okay? So I would suggest this for mild cold weather, winters, rainy days, perfect, but do not wear this under the direct sun, especially with 40-50 degrees Celsius. It's gonna give you headache, people around you gonna be falling sick. So this fragrance supposedly have opening of citrus, bergamot, and I say I get litchi and grape soda sort of vibe that many people get. And you can definitely get it, but major player in this, if you see the notes breakdown, are, I think, is amber, lavender, bergamot, and orange blossom. Orange blossom is kind of like a powdery sort of a smell if you have it in a fragrance. If you see Fleur de Mal, ideal example of orange blossom. It has a beautiful similar kind of feel to that, but that one is powerhouse in a very old school classic type way, musky, white, clean, but this is like sweet, fruity way. It comes and hits you right on the face like boom, like Ultra Male does. And this is gonna beat Ultra Male in performance, Eros in performance, anything that is clubbing, this is gonna beat that for performance. Yep. But the smell, it's citrusy. Like imagine you are having this junior, you have this small juice packs from kids store, like kids section, that you get like kind of like a milky lavender, not lavender, what I was saying, milky grape soda pop or milky grapes juice or soda pop. If you open that, like FNN in Malaysia, Fanta, if you open the grape soda, the smell you get from this. So if you like grape soda, this is your fragrance. Definitely youthful vibe, but anybody can use it. Anybody like anything, you can use it. But to me, it looks like people who are happy. Caribbean people, I really love people who live in the island. They are very happy, big-hearted mostly, and they always like to dress up, you know, easy and colorful. They're always dancing, you know, cooking, enjoying life, you know, by the beach. They're like, you know, happy people. So this is for happy people. This is for people who like living the life in colors. Okay, they do not care. They're carefree. They are not so serious. You smell this, it's a very casual fragrance. Do not wear this in workplace. I tell you, do not wear this in the workplace. People will not take you seriously. But out there, you know, outdoor activities, you're playing basketball, if you're going out with your friends, and you're just like, you know, outdoors, perfect fragrance. It's really gonna have the push. So for winter, this is a real performer. So overall, longevity and projection value, it's 10. Hands down 10. Smell, how much I like it? Do I like it over Yopalm? I like it as much as Yopalm. Yopalm, I like it about 8 out of 10. So this is kind of 8 out of 10 for the smell. Versatility, 5. It's not wearable for high heat. Age, younger age, definitely. But anybody can wear anything, so I would not put like age limit there. It's very casual, not formal. Date worthy, if you're a teenager, yes. Wear this for date. She's gonna love your sweet fragrance easily. But do not shower in this, because it's not a fragrance you need to do that with. Just go one on your chest here under your shirt, and that is gonna be enough. But if you wanna really be a show off, go like boom, boom, two side of your neck and one back of your neck. Walk like a absolute monster beast, right? That's what Silver Scent Intense gonna do. It's a nuclear fragrance, all right, right? But it's a very sweet, not scary, casual fragrance. So $20 to $25 budget. This is one of the best fragrances you can get in this price range for performance and sweet smelling. So give it a try, okay? Silver Scent Intense, I'm gonna give it 8 out of 10 for the value and overall package. Check it out, and thanks, brother, for reminding me I need to do a review. Hope you enjoy the review. Everybody take care, and thanks for watching. Maybe later tonight, review is coming up. Bye-bye.